tell us a little bit how you started this, because Christian was playing in the metro of Paris to make money. I'll tell you a funny story too.
Actually, I played in the streets of Aix-en-Provence in south of France, where I had the good luck to meet a wonderful lady named Nicola. And Nicola's here with me. We have, and she actually, she has, her father was living in Aix-en-Provence as well, and living nearby. And he was wondering why why Nicola would be interested in a man that plays the fiddle on the streets. It's not here? Do you hear the loudspeaker? I don't hear.
That was on.
Okay. Anyway, I did go as a student to the Southern France, and I was a bit short on cash, and so I did play the fiddle in front of coffee houses and streets, and had a fiddle box in front of me. And then I found out that it was actually not a bad way to earn money. And then I created a group of musicians, which are all Frenchies. French citizens. And they all had their own way of interpreting country music and bluegrass. And we ended up by being actually a bluegrass group in southern France, and we were actually invited, which is kind of really strange, to a concert of classical music, and we were the only ones that played non-classical music. But after that, actually, I just played a little bit in different places, and Paris Metro was one of them. But I think that the advantage of music, and I'll just share this with you for a second, is that it's very easy to meet people and to get to know people through and via music. Just like we met the young lady who played the violin this morning. It was out of this world for me. But I wanted to use this second just to say that if you have kids, then make sure you try to encourage them to take musical lessons, because those that don't do it regret it by the time they're in their 20s. So it's much easier to learn music when you're young, and I had the good fortune of being in a family where they're musicians, and actually, you don't know it because she's very shy. And Franz plays the viola, which is a bigger violin, more difficult to play, but she didn't decide, she didn't offer to say, well, let's play together. But anyway, so in their 81st birthday.
Oh, you want me to do that?
Thanks very much. Pleasure to be here. Your hat looks very funny. It looks like you're on a horse. It never stops.
Well, I wanted to also tell you a funny story about Christian. I was offered a job by AIB, and I'm still sitting in the living room, and I was telling people that I'll be happy to tell me about the job, and I say, that was in Rabat, and I say, oh, by the way, do you know Criss Juliard? And they say, oh, sure, we're in his orchestra. So I've gone to Chris in Haiti, in Madagascar, in Morocco, but so I've even stayed with Chris and his wife. Chris and I have followed each other, although he's in development and I was born in education. So, my great brother, and thank you so much, Nicola and Chris, for coming. That's very special.
They came all the way from Portland.
So, they're retired.